Welcome to another new game, Firewatch.
Yep.
And can I use a controller for this? Sweet. So let's get into it. New game. I only know a little about this game. First of all, you are in the woods and you need to make sure there's no forest fires. Okay, I don't know that much. I've got a walkie-talkie, I know that. You can pick up a disposable camera, I know that. It's a very pretty game, I know that. There's some creepy mystery stuff. Boulder, Colorado, 1975. Nice. Oops. You see Julia? No, I don't. Despite your age, late 20s, laughing, well-dressed, professors and grad students from nearby see you boulder. You, Henry, are out drinking with your pals. You approach her. You are drunk. So, what's your, major? You're pretty. You're pretty, she says coolly. You are not. You are future hangover. What? You reply, confused. Someone should buy you a cheeseburger, she says. She flags down a waiter. 1 week later, you are Julia's boyfriend. Okay. Cool. Right, well, it's telling me keyboard buttons, although I'm using the controller, which is useful. I guess that's my truck. Can I pick up random crap? Whoa! I have a body! I have legs, I have feet. That's always useful. Don't know why I left my truck bed down. You date for over a year, she drives you absolutely nuts, it's great. You move in, you share an apartment near the school with a view of the mountains. You two drink beers on the deck. You drink beer just about anywhere. Life is good. Julia wants to get a dog. You get a dog. There's scruffy, undersized beagle. Julia's in love. She wants to bring it with her to class. There's also an taming but gently German shepherd. Nothing bad could happen to Julia while walking this dog. It's badass. Kind of the German shepherd. Screw Julia. Mayhem is an excellent dog. He loves wrestling with you in the park and goes with Julia on her runs. Even though she's too big to bring to school, Julia loves him all the same. Mayhem's friend, pet. Do these choices... Are these important? You talk out in the deck. It's summer, 9:30 p.m. And the heat still radiates off the high desert. So what do you think about kids, she asks. Kids, they're not very smart, argued it much. I'm saying if you and I have a couple of little idiots, one day, why rush? Okay, in that case we should probably get married. Yeah. Hey. Yeah, I would like that. You say these kids are going to be screwed up enough. It's probably best if that their parents are hitched. You see, she's absolutely right. Is that how we get engaged? I have awfully chubby fingers. There's a lot of reading in this game. Is that it? It's Thursday night and Julie is 4 hours late. She doesn't call. You're worried. You're getting angrier by the minute. She walks in after you've gone to bed. She's not quite drunk, but she's clearly been having fun time. You fight when she gets in between the sheets. Get mad or ignore her. You don't touch each other all night. The next day you feel guilty for being so angry and ask her about her evening. She says it was great. Hold on to a tiny pill of resentment. You make some coffee and go to work. Julia still likes to draw. She draws plants from her research. She draws all the places you go. She draws you. Pulls and flex like He-Man. You look awesome. Whoa, crazy zoom button. Run button. Two forks. During the summers, you and Julia enjoy walking mayhem. At night, there is a festival in town. It brings in folks from faraway places. One of them tries to mug you with a knife. Mayhem runs away. Mayhem move, fucking dog, Julia yells, frustrated. She has trouble speaking when she is stressed. You confront the attacker. Scare him away. You reach into your pocket like you've got a gun and threaten to kill him. You manage to scare all three of you. He runs away. Julia asks you to take a different path from that day forward. You say, okay, I don't want to go that way either. From then on, you walk by the river. Plans to have kids way late. Waylaid because of work. Julie gets offered a job at Yale. Yale is Connecticut, 2,000 miles away. It's a great job, associate department chair. She wants to move. You absolutely do not. You ask her if she'll commute back and forth. You don't want to move to Connecticut. She says that'll be hard, but she'll do it if you won't move. You tell her to pass it up if that's what you tell her not to pass it up if that's what she wants. She agrees. She flies back to Boulder 3 times a semester. Julia is sent home from Yale on paid leave after having an episode. She lost it on a colleague for borrowing books that were important to her research. She didn't remember she'd happily loaned them to him 2 days prior. She was found crying in the stairwell. I said After seeing multiple doctors and having many tests, you're worried that Julia might be suffering from early onset dementia. She is 41. Dementia at 41. You both decide to keep it a secret for now. Some camping. Ha! A nudie picture of me dressed as a He-Man. Mayhem is getting older. He's got silver hair down to back and it slows down at night. You and Julia walk him to the bar. You see your friends and it feels like nothing has changed. Julia goes back to university. Julia's affliction gets worse. She can't remember things in class. Her research is in shambles. She drives her car to the next town over for no particular reason and has to be brought home by the police. She's devastated. She's sent home on permanent medical leave. Some days you get the Julia who calls you dope and your unborn children little idiots. Other days you get a stranger. She pulls you into bed to make love. After 5 minutes she goes into a panic, believing her dad is at the door. You tell her family they are crushed and begin to make trips to and from their home in Australia to visit her for a while. Your friends come by with little things to brighten her day. She gets worse. 1988. You spend your days following Julia around the house. You count the seconds between the 2 weekly visits from Daniel the nurse. He suggests that Julia could live somewhere else, somewhere with 24-hour care. A home sits with you for a couple of months. You decide to move her into a full-time care facility, or you determined to look after yourself. I might try the keyboard if it feels better. Do you know what? I think I like the controller. It's a bit smoother. Ooh, dear. Come back. It's impossibly hard. The worst is when you get mad at her, like when she tries to cook her own food. You can't do anything without her, and she can't do anything without you. When she goes to sleep, you stay up for a few hours, drinking on the deck, watching baseball in the summer, college basketball in the winter, drinking then too. Start going out after you put her to bed. The first time you do it, you worry about her getting up and walking around while you're gone. You put a chair in front of the bedroom door. Go to the same bar at the boring end of Pearl Street. It's nicer. Over time, you tell Sheila, the bartender, everything. It's a huge weight off. You're home in bed at 1 a.m. a couple of nights a week. You look forward to those nights. One time you're stopped at DUI checkpoint, you blow a .10 and are taken to jail for the night. You consider trying to hide it, but you tell your sister-in-law Susan. Julia's parents take the next plane from Australia. They can't believe the state the house is in. They then tell you Julia's coming to live with them. You don't argue, you'll say you'll visit soon. A few weeks go by, summer's coming, and you see an ad in the paper for a job. I think this is You Take It. And this is Firewatch. This is the job, I believe. Right, I wonder if those choices have anything to do... Enter the lookout tower. This would be the job. I'm looking forward to when I can actually go for a proper wander. If that's how this game plays out. As I said, I don't know too much about it. I think it's just an exploration game. Ooh, a little poop house out there. This reminds me of... what's that survival game? The wintery one.
Tower.
Oh, alone.
Two Forks Tower, this is Thoroughfare Tower. Come in.
Hello?
Hello? Whoever this is?
It's Henry, right?
Yeah.
I'm Delilah.
Yeah, that's what the guy said on the phone.
So, what's wrong with you?
Excuse me?
People take this job to get away from something. So, what's wrong?
What's wrong with you?
That's a great idea. Go ahead.
Look, I just hiked for 2 days, so I don't really follow whatever it is you're doing right now.
You take a stab at what's wrong with me.
Fine. Then, can I... sleep? Forever?
Sure, buddy. Okay, now go ahead.
Okay, you're probably just rebelling against a mom who wishes you had given her grandkids, by the sound of your voice, at least 15 years ago. You come out here and it really grinds her gears and you love it. Can I sleep now?
Well, she also says I fuck immature men, but in my defense, who wouldn't want a 28-year-old with ambition and energy and some fire in his belly in bed?
Me, I'm going now.
Just a second, now it's my turn.
Okay, good night, bye.
Let's see. I don't know anything about you. But maybe you just really like trees. Maybe it's... Gosh, maybe it's a borderline fetish. A tree fetish.
Good night.
Good night. Welcome to the job.
Firewatch. There you go. That's neat. I like that. I did not realize it was a woman at the other end.
Slept like a rock. Anyway, there's still a few hours of daylight to get some work in. I can see you at your desk, so call me when you're ready.
Hey, sorry, guess I slept in.
You got a relaxing, what, 14 hours of sleep? Woo.
Yeah, Jesus, I guess it's, what, 6?
6:45.
Whoops.
Don't worry about it. That hike puts everyone out of commission for a day or two. But now that you're up, let me quickly get you acquainted with the job. There's a thing in the middle of your room with a round map on it. Do you see it?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, I see it.
This is the Osborne Firefinder, invented in 1914 by W.B.
Osborne?
You use this to spot, you guessed it, what the fuck?
What is it?
Nothing. You use this to... Oh, fuck me!
Good God, language, lady.
Out your west-facing window. Are you seeing what I'm seeing?
Fireworks.
Are those fucking fireworks? Do you see them?
Whoa, that's not legal, right?
No. You need to get down. down there right now and stop them. Fire danger is through the fucking roof.
Is that really my job?
Your job is whatever I say it is. Look, the closest ranger is like 2 days away. Go down there and set them straight. Do you think you can handle that?
Do I write him a ticket?
Easy there, Dirty Harry.
Well?
Get going. You'll probably need a rope to get down the shale between you and the lake, if I remember right. There should be one in the supply box on the way. The code is 1234. It's actually that for all of them.
Secure.
Shut up.
Oh, I take my bag with me. Anyway, I was trying to pick that up. Bing. Oh, the little animations are lovely in this. Do I have this whole map? Oh, I'm going totally the wrong way. Ah, idiot me. What a good looking game, this is nice. Just a little walk through the woods.
Found the supply box.
Great.
People lose their shit doing this job. There's a note that says a guy just left his post.
It happens, yeah. You're not gonna pop your top, are you, Henry?
I wasn't planning on it.
There we go. Right, now I've got Xbox controls on the screen. Medicine wheel. Okay. Well, we're just heading to the lake, aren't we? Take that down. That's what these buttons do. Right, much better with the Xbox controls on screen, because the keyboard ones were confusing while I was using this. It's such a peaceful game. I'm glad I stuck this one on just before I went to bed. I was going to save it till tomorrow, I'm glad I did it now.
This shale slide is steep. How do you expect me to get down this?
I don't remember it being that bad. It's not even named on our topos. What's wrong with you?
My rope snapped coming down the shale slide.
You didn't break anything, did you?
No, I think I'll make it.
Well, be careful for Christ's sake.
Pretty dark out here.
Hey, there's a tie-off point off here, just a little way from the shale slide.
Well, you ready to get back on that horse, huh?
Well, I can't go any further, is what I'm saying.
That heads south down to the creek, but you should be able to get to the lake just by continuing west. Without any, you know, mountaineering.
All right.
It's a long summer. You can explore later.
It is a hell of a nice camping spot down here by the lake.
I haven't been down there in years, but yeah, Jonesy Lake area is perfect.
I'm staring at the big outcropping down here, but I'm not quite sure where to look for our pyrotechnicians.
Maybe keep heading west toward the lake.
Finding a bunch of empty beer cans, they threw them all over hell.
Are you fucking serious?
Yeah, sure am.
People are just the worst, aren't they?
Yes.
They're not great,
people,
no.
People are awful.
Oh, look, they decided to have a campfire, too.
You know, they color-coded the fire danger signs in case people were illiterate. But I guess that doesn't take into account just plain stupid, does it?
They left half a bottle of whiskey. Decent stuff.
Drunk pyromaniacs. Fucking great.
Found the fireworks. They didn't even try to hide them.
Well, confiscate them.
ferret are Irish. They left their packs tied up here.
Don't fuck with them. The last thing we need is some hikers filing a report about harassment.
Well, I put out their fire.
Man, I would have named that forest fire something good, too.
Hey, I can always restart it.
No. I think your first instinct was the right one.
What do you know? People with shitty manners drink shitty beer.
What, you don't like a cold musquelite on a hot day?
No, I do. But then again, I didn't say my manners were any good. Better than these fucking litter bugs, though, that's for sure.
Gonna tidy up their shit. Wonder where they went. Wonder if there's people in this game. Wonder if I get extra points for doing all the cleaning.
Well, they left their clothes out to dry. It looks like two people. What if they're naked?
Won't that be exciting? Look, they're obviously still there, so tell them off and then head back.
I found a bra.
A nudie pyromaniac. Remain professional.
There are, panties.
There are what?
I don't want to say that word again.
Why, because you're 12?
You can touch the panties, can I touch the bra? Oh, let me touch the bra. Do not put it back up.
Yes?
There are two naked ladies out here.
Can you handle that?
Come on, I like naked ladies, same as anyone, but there's, you know.
Two?
Yeah.
I know this will be tough for you, but try to pick your tongue up off the ground and do your job.
Okay. I found them in the lake.
Skinny dipping?
Yeah.
Is that a guy over there?
Oh boy. Enjoy dealing with that.
Go stereo!
Oh, hey! Put that down! Seriously, it was expensive!
Fucking cool it with the fireworks!
Please just put it down! We won't light anymore!
You gotta take it easy with the fireworks, all right?
You ought to take it easy at the Sizzler buffet.
Chelsea?
What? He's just some loser out in the woods. I mean, he's grody. Why do guys think it's all right to just stare at girls?
Took all of your stuff. Fireworks, whiskey, you name it.
What?
You dick!
Also, setting off fireworks out here isn't just stupid, it's illegal.
Yeah, so is stealing, asshole.
That's so fucking bogus.
You're gonna pay for that.
Can we just get out of here?
Ew, totally.
You're gross.
You're just so sad you're out in the woods.
I
can I not take the radio?
Hey, that go okay?
It's done.
Well, that's ominous.
Hopefully there won't be any more trouble.
Good. Thanks for going down there.
Alright, make my way back. I'll leave your stuff there. Wonder what else will happen on the way. Oh jeez, it's been a pretty long episode.
Hey, I'm back near that big rock outcropping, but not sure how to get back.
I'd head west, back towards the lake, and then turn north towards the canyon.
I can't go back this way, can I? Ah, goddammit. Gotta go back to the goddamn lake.
Okay, so from these rocks, where do I go again?
Go back towards the lake, turn north, and east through the canyon. There should be a trail at the far east side of it.
Oh, okay. Back to the music again. Pass, pass, pennies.
There's a trail to Two Forks Tower down here near the lake.
Yeah, that's your tower.
So I should go this way.
Well, you're not climbing back up that slide.
I thought this would be a bigger river. Very orange out here. Yeah, this is running a wee bit long.
I have a bit of a confession to make.
What is it?
Look, I was drunk last night when I welcomed you to the job.
Yeah, well, you're not the first boss to be guilty of that.
I know, I know I can get a little pushy, you know, putting you on the spot about why you're out here and stuff.
And you thought it was a good idea to get into your love life, I guess you'd call it?
sorry.
It's fine.
I'll keep that sort of a thing to a minimum. Anyway, let me know when you get back to your lookout.
Pretty dark.
Hey, I heard some thunder.
Yeah, I've got eyes on a storm out to the north.
Well, that's bad, right? Because of the lightning?
It just means we'll be busy. Hurry home and try not to get hit by lightning.
I got hit by lightning when I was 9 years old, so I'm safe. It's not gonna strike twice and all that.
Well, there was an old lookout named Roy Sullivan who got hit by lightning 7 times.
I don't like the sound of that.
Yeah, well, if it makes you feel any better, it wasn't what killed him.
What killed him?
Suicide. Would you believe?
I like this cache copying bits of the map. That's cool.
Ah.
There's a horn or an antler or whatever.
Well, antlers are made of bone, and horns are made of the same stuff as your fingernails.
I guess this is a bone.
Antler. A ranger must have found it this spring.
Go into that goddamn box! Right, let's figure out. So I want to go through here?
What's in this cave down here?
In Thunder Canyon?
Thunder Canyon?
Hey, I didn't name it. But in the cave? I don't know, rocks? NFS tells people not to go too far in there. It's pretty dangerous.
This cave is gated off.
It's to stop spelunkers from dying without getting the keys from the Forest Service office first.
Makes sense.
Although, Debbie says she lost them like 3 years ago, so maybe its mysteries are locked away for good.
That's too bad. I used to go caving in Colorado a lot with someone. It would be really nice to pick that back up. It looks like the path leads through the cave.
Back in the cave, huh? Man, I don't need to lose another lookout in there.
Another lookout?
They go in, they never come out.
So this is another one of your jokes.
Yeah, it is. Yep.
Hello? I bless the rains down in Africa!
singing a bit of Toto, I like. Hope I'm going the right way. I didn't realize this was such a open space in this game.
There's some guy out here giving me the creeps.
The creeps? Wait, he's looking at you? Is he doing anything else?
I don't think so.
Henry, there's something something someone should have told you about this area.
What is it?
It's outside.
Come on.
The whole thing. And people come and go as they please. It's madness.
Yeah, okay. I get it.
Look, bumping into someone in the middle of nowhere is part of the fun.
That animation was a bit crappy, I have to say. It looked a bit weird. It's not the ranger, that's the other ranger station, right? This way, is this where the guy was? He didn't leave anything behind. No clue who he is. So, this game's just going to be seeing people off in the distance, mostly. I'm getting the impression. You see people, but you don't really see people. Good that he's good at climbing, but I mean, isn't this guy about 50 now? He's pretty old, right?
Damn it. Well, that trail isn't closed anymore.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I took care of the blocked path. It was backbreaking, but. You know, anything for the service.
Well, thank you.
Anytime.
Sis?
So it's just the outhouse then, in terms of going to the bathroom?
You're a man, Henry. You can go wherever you want. Well, number one at least. And, full disclosure, I pee wherever I want as well.
So this generator is all the power I've got out here.
Yep, it doesn't go through much gas, and, well, you don't have much in the way of electronics, so...
What about my hairdryer?
Oh, I'm sorry. You might just have to make peace with frizzy locks.
I could never. You know, I don't think there's any fictional character I hate more than Forrest Burns.
Henry, as an employee of the Forest Service, that is treason.
Yeah, well, he really freaked me out as a kid.
He inspired me to spend the bulk of my 30s keeping the wilderness safe.
A shrink would have a field day with you.
Thanks, Mom.
What kind of name is Forrest Burns, anyway?
Well, that would be a pun, Hank. A glorious pun.
I went to junior high with a guy named Royal Butts.
Royal?
Butts.
I didn't think anyone had been named Royal since the 1850s.
Well, Royal's mom, Flo, was a bit of a trendsetter.
Flo Butts? Oh, man, that's even worse.
Yeah, well, it's still better than Forrest Burns.
What can I do for you?
Well, my typewriter is on the ground, outside of my tower.
You write?
Yeah, look, the wind? No. How the hell...
You should get inside.
Fuck me.
The fuck? Someone trash man. See what's happening here.
someone broke in.
They what?
They wrecked the place. Threw my typewriter out the window. Motherfucker!
Holy shit. I'll let the Forest Service know what happened.
What can they do about it? Will they catch whoever did it?
This is the Forest Service, Henry. They're not exactly Hawaii 5-0. Do you have any idea who would have done this?
I did probably piss off the girls at the lake. Ugh, fuck them.
Well, I'll have the Rangers keep an eye out for a couple of young women and question any they find. I can't believe someone would do this. I worry about bears and fires, and that's about it. And now I've got to worry about some, violent campers? Okay, in the morning I'm gonna call my friend Patty, who works the desk down in Cody. They keep a list of everyone who's officially been in and out of the trailhead since, I don't know, forever, and see if we can get a list of names. We won't get much, but at least if anything else happens, we can refer to it and see if anything comes up.
Thanks.
I need you to feel safe out here.
Don't worry about it.
Oh, you can protect yourself, huh?
I just don't worry about it.
Perfect. Keep that attitude up and you'll have an excellent summer.
D2. All right. Well, that's
Post game. Hey, wake up.
Sorry, I was pressing the wrong button there. All right, that's where I am going to end the episode. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this, please press the like button. If you go on in, then say, leave it in the comments. Otherwise, I will see you in the next episode. Cheers. Bye-bye.